Warmly welcome you all. I'm UGD Madhushika. I'm here to present my research findings on life cycle cost comparison of indirect green facade versus conventional wall, a case of a Tempest residential facility. This is the presentation outline. First of all, I would like to move on to the background of this study. Why we need this green wall concept? Urbanization reduces the plant coverage as a result of that global warming take place. So people tend to consume more energy to fulfill their ventilation requirement. So most of building designers consider about the more energy efficient building designs. This natural integration of natural vegetation into the building is the one focus on that. Green wall is the one solution to integrate natural vegetation into the building. Then I move on to the research problem of this study. Though the whole world leads toward the green wall application, Sri Lanka is still at the infancy stage, though Sri Lanka faces energy crisis too. The main reason for that is the perception of the high initial cost of green walls compared to the conventional wall. However, this negative effect of the initial cost can be offset by considering the long-term benefits of green walls, such as energy cost saving. Most of researchers focus mainly on the benefit, environmental impacts, and the economic assessment of the green walls comparing the different green wall types. However, it seems to be there is a limited focus on the life cycle cost of green walls compared to the conventional wall, which is an essential requirement to effectively adaptation of the green wall concept, because the main reason to less adaptation of green wall concept is high initial cost of green wall compared to the conventional wall. So this research is aimed to assess the life cycle cost of green wall compared to the conventional wall and thereby promote the green wall application in Sri Lanka. These are the four objectives which are used to achieve this aim. In this study, it is limited to the life cycle cost assessment of indirect green facade type applied in the selected facility. Then I move on to the research methodology. Initially, background study was conducted and then identified the research problem as I mentioned in the previous slide. Then literature review was conducted to achieve the objective one. Preliminary investigation was conducted to achieve the objective two. Latter part of the preliminary investigation helped to identify the most suitable research case for the case study, and the case study analysis was helped to achieve the objective three and objective four. Finally, arrived into the conclusions and recommendation. In this study, mixed approach was used as the research approach. Then case study strategy was used as the research strategy. Documentary review, on-site measurement are the main data collection techniques, and the mean value calculation and life cycle cost analysis is the data analysis techniques in this study. Then I move on to the achievement of each objectives. Objective one achieved through the literature findings. First of all, we need to understand what is green wall. It is all forms of vegetated wall surface. These are the main categories of green walls, and these are the main benefit which I identified through the literature review. Building energy cost saving is the significant benefit of green wall. And these are the barriers which I identified through the literature review, and the high initial cost compared to the conventional wall is the most common barrier in both local and international contexts. These are the economic performance of green walls according to the current studies. These two studies show the economic performance of different types of green walls, and the last two studies shows the comparison between the one type of green wall with the conventional wall. However, this first three studies findings cannot be directly applied to the Sri Lankan context when considered the geographical constraint. But this study is limited to the Sri Lanka. It is considered the direct green facade with the conventional wall. The findings of the CBA cost benefit analysis is not comply with the other literature findings available. So there is the needness of the assessment of the economy of green wall compared to the conventional wall, because the main barrier towards the implementation of green wall is the higher initial cost of green wall compared to the conventional wall. Then I move on to the achievement of objective two, extent of green wall application in Sri Lanka. Among the identified 43 green wall cases through the preliminary investigation, as shown in this graph, indirect green facade is the most commonly available type. This graph shows the green wall application is spread in different properties, including hotel, industries, residential, office, educational, religious, and buildings. Furthermore, this graph shows those different properties use different green wall types. It could be due to the intention and the purpose of that building. Then I move on to the case study analysis. For that, two buildings were considered. One is building with green wall and other one is building without green wall. Considered green wall type is the indirect green facade because from the preliminary investigation, I had identified that the indirect green facade is the most commonly available green wall type. This table shows the physical characteristic of both buildings and it shows those characteristics are almost similar. But when considered the exterior dimension, length and width of the indirect green facade building is higher compared to the conventional wall building. So in the further analysis, values were considered per square meter. Then I move on to the achievement of objective 3, comparison of thermal performance, green wall versus conventional wall. Temperature measurements were taken for 14 days in both internal and external wall of each building for 5 time intervals per day. Then mean temperatures were calculated and calculated average surface temperature was shown in this table. As per this table, conventional wall building average surface temperature is higher in terms of location as well as the facade orientation than the indirect green facade building. These values we can convert into the heat transfer amount by using this formula, and the final result shows that the heat transfer to the indirect green facade is lesser compared to the conventional wall. Then I move on to the comparison of life cycle cost of green wall versus conventional wall. For that, initially need to identify the what are the life cycle stage and the cost component. These two graph, two tables clearly shows the initial cost component and maintenance stage cost component of each building. According to those two tables, it is clear that in both cases, indirect green facade shows higher cost component than the conventional wall building. Furthermore, in maintenance phase, indirect green facade building shows the higher time gap than the conventional wall building for the external painting. This is due to the indirect green facade building is act as the protective layer for the external wall surface of that building. Then I move on to the operational cost of this study. In this study, we considered that energy requirement for ventilation is directly proportionate to the heat transfer through the walls. Then by using the CEB 2020 unit rates, we calculate the energy consumption for the month and concluded that the indirect green facade building shows 68% of energy cost saving than the conventional wall building per month. This table shows the life cycle cost calculation of conventional wall and the indirect green facade. As we identified from the literature review, initial cost of green wall is higher compared to the conventional wall, and it is a 15% benefit to the conventional wall. However, when we move on to the operational and maintenance phase, it is benefit to the green wall. So when consider the total life cycle of the green wall, it is beneficial to the green wall by 45%. So to validate this results of this study further, sensitivity analysis was carried out, and the result of sensitivity analysis also showed that the, in every lifetime and every discount rate, life cycle cost of green wall is lesser compared to the conventional wall. Then I move on to the conclusions of this study. Indirect green facade type is the most popular and commonly available green wall type in Sri Lanka to date. Significant energy cost saving benefit can be obtained by the indirect green facades in operational stage. Further, this negative effect of the higher initial cost of green walls can be offset when considering the operational cost saving and the maintenance cost saving. So, indirect green facade building shows the 45% of life cycle cost saving compared to the conventional wall. Finally, it can be concluded that the green wall can be used as the alternative option to as a solution to improve the vegetation in dense urban areas by considering its benefit. These are the recommendation and further research areas. Thank you.